Come on, you stupid voice. Harold frantically grabbed his lamp. Harold incensed shook the hell out of it for no apparent reason. Smashed it on the ground, kicking it repeatedly. Harold took his Kleenex box, threw it across the room, then stormed the closet! Come on, say something. Something! Say something! Say something!
Harold. Harold, listen to me. Harold, you will die someday, sometime. Heart failure at the bank. Choke on a mint. Some long drawn out disease you contracted on vacation. You will die. You will absolutely die. Even if you avoid this death, another will find you. And I guarantee that it won't be nearly as poetic or meaningful as what she's written. I'm sorry, but it's the nature of all tragedies, Harold. The hero dies, but the story goes on forever.
How many people do you think I've killed?
Kay.
How many?
I don't know.
Eight.
I've
killed eight people, counted.
They're fictional.
Harold Crick isn't fictional.
Alfie.
He isn't fictional, Penny. Every book I've ever written ends with someone dying, everyone. Really nice people, too.
I'll purchase them.
No.
No, really, I'd like to purchase them. What are they?
Flowers.
What?
I brought you flowers.
And you carried them all the way here?
It's her masterpiece. It's possibly the most important novel in her already stunning career. It's absolutely no good unless you die at the end. I've been over it again and again, and I know how hard this is for you to hear.
You're asking me to knowingly face my death?
Yes.
Really?
You just...
Yeah, I read it all in one read on the bus. It's lovely. I like the part about the guitars.
I thought you'd find something.
I'm sorry, Harold.
Well,
look,
listen, I'm...
No, I read it, and I loved it.
Dad?
And there's only one way it can end. I mean, I don't have much background in literary anything, but this seems simple enough. I love your book, and I think you should finish it.